The tower. Somebody said the tower.
The tower.
What is it for?
It's right in the
The tower. What is it for? Brother, in my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved. Brother, in my heart's desire and prayer to God for America is that they're saved. Brother, in my heart's desire and prayer to God for Mount Canaan and other churches is that you'll save. Look at your neighbor. That's the only kind of church God is looking for. The only kind of church God can use is a saved church.
Amen.
One that has been saved from themselves. And some of y'all got a living testimony. Oh, some of y'all thought you couldn't live without a liquor bottle. Now you won't even run over it when it's in the road, in with your car. You'll go around it some kind of way. Amen. Some of you have been exposed to everything from marijuana all the way to crack cocaine. But it was something inside of you that would not let you stay where the devil had you bound. And today you can say that I ain't all I need to be, but thank God I ain't what I used to be. I ain't perfect, but I'm saved. Ain't the Lord all right? God loves saved folks. God loves a saved church. A church where folks don't let their ego get in the way. A church where folks don't tear up the church based on what they want. But it's not theirs anyway. It all belongs to God. Ain't the Lord all right? God wants saved folks who are his folks. And he is their development, their elevation, and their prosperity. If you were totally trusting God, you wouldn't have anything to worry about. God wants somebody that's dug up out of the muck and the mire. Through it all, he demands that his children stay true. Amen. See, a lot of us want to run up the road and stop. You should have been in Sunday school this morning. Some of y'all want to take on positions, but you don't want to run. Some of you want to resign, but don't nobody know you resign but you. Ain't the Lord all right? But God wants some folks that will stay true and stay dedicated to the God of their salvation. Jehovah, Yahweh, the maker and creator of this universe. Here God had purged his people. He had already sent the flood. And he had already pulled Noah out of the group. I got a little bit discouraged last week, and I thought about it. I said, Noah had to build a whole ark by himself. At least you got 25 or 30 people who got the sleeves rolled up. All of them haven't gone to work yet, but at least they got the sleeves rolled up. And they're giving you a sign that I'll be to work one day sooner or later. But Noah didn't have anybody but himself. He had to hew the logs. He had to cut the logs. He had to fit them together. He had to paste them together. He had to mortar them together. Then he had to go recruit the animals to come on board. And try to get the people around them to come on board. But nobody but eight people stepped on board. Ain't the Lord all right? We got a whole lot more than eight folks, don't we? But we better off than Noah is. God has already ordained his people. Oh, there's a lot of places you could have been this morning, but you're in the house of the Lord. So you don't know why you came. The time changed, and some folks in your house didn't come. Folks came to you, even tried to discourage you from coming, but you came anyhow.
Amen.
Some of you didn't feel that coming. You thought. But now you feel 10 times better than you did when you walked in the door.
Yeah.
Huh? Isn't the Lord all right? Because God's blessings were already here for you. And God had purged his people. He had already sent the flood. And here they are trying to reestablish themselves after the flood. As the people of God, who were Noah's seed, tried to reestablish, they were together. Somebody say together.
Yeah.
And they were on what?
One accord.
The even Jesus said, where two or three are gathered together.
Yeah.
But you got to be touching.
Yeah.
That's written, it's all right to hold hands sometimes.
Yeah.
And you got to be agreeing.
Yeah.
He said, if you touch it and agreeing, I would be in the midst of it.
Yeah.
And he said, one person can defeat a thousand.
Yeah.
And two people who really in the spirit can put 10,000 to a flight.
Yeah.
Well, if two can run 10,000, God, look how many of y'all in here.
Yeah.
We could put Augusta and Columbia County on the run today.
Yeah.
If the Lord's spirit would really do what? Soak in.
Yeah.
Huh? They were together and one accord. They were bent on survival and for development.
Yeah.
But look at verse 1 and verse 2. And the whole earth was of many languages.
One language.
And y'all wonder how we get so confused. The Bible has already told you. Because of the indignation of man.
Amen.
And that's the reason we got so many folks of so many different backgrounds.
Yeah.
But at one point, they all had one language and one speech.
Yeah.
And it came to pass as they journeyed from the east that they found a plain in the land of Shinar. And they dwelt there. Isn't the Lord all right?
Yeah.
As the people of God came together, they were of oneness. They were together.
Yeah.
Survival was guaranteed. Development was guaranteed. We find that everyone had the same value system. And not only did they have the same value system, they spoke one language.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
They could interchange ideas freely. And that was sufficient.
Yeah.
One people.
Uh-huh.
One language.
Yeah.
One focus. I hate to tell you about it, but God's coming back looking for one language, one people, one custom, and one focus when it comes to the word of God. The people of God came to Shinar in the area that we call Mesopotamia, which only means between two rivers. They were between the Euphrates River and the Tigris River. The area was well watered and could go grow grain and all the necessities that the people needed.
Yes.
According to the writings of the historian Herodotus, this area spawned the cities of Erech, the city of Akkad, the city of Canaan, and the city of Babylon.
Yeah.
And that's the city that we are interested in this morning.
Hallelujah.
They stayed in Mesopotamia.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Yeah. Some of y'all thought world history was boring and you had it right in your Bible all the time. They stayed in Mesopotamia and they did not scatter because of the richness of the area.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes.
But sometimes folk got a rich area and can't see it.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, well, y'all might well say amen. Mount Canaan is scattered because some of our people could not see the richness of the area.
Yeah.
Because they were like my neighbor that moved out and let his house go. Huh? They use the fact that I don't have a job. I know y'all don't want to say amen, but in days past, you know, somebody in my family was unemployed. And they were crying the blues. And they were saying, you know that you got connection. You know everybody in Edgefield. And so I called Bettis Rasmus, who was the top cat. I won't say top dog. Amen. But he was the top cat at that time. And I called Bettis and I said, Bettis, can you meet with me a little while? He said, yeah, George, come on up then. So I went on up to his office. And I told him, he said, well, he said, they're doing something over at the Wild Turkey Federation. He said, I can drop the name of your kin person and tell them to get a resume up. And I saw his heart was really what he was saying. But he was just giving me words. And so when he got to the end of it, he stopped and he said something I never forget. He said, George, when you get back home, tell that person, have they ever thought about creating their own job? Mm-hmm. As long as they tied to the Turkey Federation, they're going to have to do what the Turkey says. Well, I know y'all don't want to hear. Because you want to be like those fellows who scratch their head and say, Lord, we can't go no further. Cause.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Do you look at the boxing, and I've said this 1,000 times, do you look at the boxing on some of these folk houses in this area?
Well,
you can get you a bucket of paint and get in a pickup truck and just go do boxing for about 3 or 4 months and have more money than you know what to do with. Wow. I have a deacon right here in this church that lost his job. And he got a good skill, and the folk had it so busy, he stopped me right out there. He said, right out. He said, your son was mean something to me. I said, yeah. He said, I lost my job, but I keep more money in my pocket now than I did when I was working. Because I took what God gave me.
Yes.
Y'all don't want to hear that. Y'all don't want to hear that. Huh?
Yeah.
Ain't the Lord all right?
Yeah.
They stayed because of the richness of the area.
Yeah.
And that's what folks do. Rather than venturing out on the promises of God. Mm-hmm. Verses 3 and 4. And they said one to another, go to, let us make brick and burn them thoroughly. And they had brick for stone, and slime had they for mortar. Mm-hmm. Ain't the Lord all right?
Yeah.
And they said, go to, let us build us a city and a tower. And this is where they made a mistake. Whose top may do what? Reach up into. And let us make a name.
Yeah.
Lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the earth. In other words, let us be somebody.
Yeah.
Let our name mean something.
Uh-huh.
Let the folks in Mount Canaan nod a little bit when I walk in 35 minutes late. Amen. So I know that I am somebody.
Yeah.
Let me drive a certain car that folks will stop and look at in awe, so that they will know that I represent something. I'm not just anybody, but I am somebody.
Amen, amen.
Well, honey, I got bad news for you. This younger group didn't care nothing about your car.
Amen.
Huh? You can drive up in a Mercedes and the person drive up in a Ford and they don't even know which one came in the Ford and they don't know which one came in the Mercedes.
Amen.
Ain't the Lord all right?
Amen.
Don't ever let a car define
Amen.
Who you are. Drive what you want to. Overcome this world when you've overcome this world, you can drive whatever you want, because God knows that you're not going to be sucked in by a piece of iron or steel with four rubber tires on it. Well, I don't care if you get a Ferrari, and I don't care if you pay $500,000 for it. It doesn't have a four tires on it. One engine, one transmission. Between two and four seats. Amen. And it will get you there, but it ain't guaranteed to get you back home. Ain't it all right? They wanted something permanent, so they made their own bricks and mortar. You young people never heard of that before. Have folks around here, especially black folks, have they ever made their own bricks and mortar? Where did they make it? At Bethesda Academy. Do y'all realize that those two buildings down there, they're still standing and they're still looking good? Do you know students built those buildings and they made their own stones and their own mortar? Led by a man that everybody know that they're going to honor next Sunday night by the name of Jethro McCain. I told you we don't know who we are. We are there teaching at Payne College. Oh, somebody said, bless Payne College.
Bless Payne College.
And tell the Negroes over there to stay out of money to camera so much. Amen. Don't nobody want to know that they can't make their payroll.
Yes.
That's the in-house thing.
Amen.
That make folks not give when they... Man at the bank told me, oh, I won't say what he said. Anyway, it sets me up. Shut your mouth up.
Yeah.
You know what you need to do. Pray for it. Pray for it, because it's so sad. I told somebody this morning when they closed paying, I hope I'll be somewhere, and it ain't going to be nice, because Noah got drunk, and I might have to get drunk. Amen. It's hard to watch our institutions die when nobody seems to be getting upset about it. Nobody getting upset about it. We don't even mention pain in our prayers. And the doors are almost closed. I hate to tell you, the doors are almost closed. The man told us 6 months ago that he had enough money to get into November. What is today? And they announced Friday they couldn't make money. Whew. I'm ready to sit down now. But we get into lofty classrooms, and I did it. I talked about Booker T. Washington and how Booker T. Washington had his people to set up kilns on the campus. And they made their own bricks and they made their own stones at Tuskegee University. And the university was built primarily by students. Do y'all realize members of Mount King made bricks? It's no accident that J.C. Williams was one of the best brick masons in the United States, because he came where it was rooted. Came where it was given to them. They were born doing it. That's the same thing they did in the Bible. They made their own bricks and they made their own mortar so that they could build them a place of permanency. Because see, everybody during this time just about was nomadic. And people who were nomadic never could sink their roots in the ground because they were constantly moving. You got to stay somewhere in order to prosper, development, and perpetuate. You're running somewhere every 5 minutes. They had 10 jobs in 7 months. And wonder why you can't prosper. Because you don't anchor yourself down. Huh? They wanted permanency. Visualize houses they could build with bricks and mortar. Buildings, schools, banks, churches. God had put them where they could really prosper. But the reason they didn't prosper is many of them wanted to carry out not God's agenda, but their own agenda. Amen. They wanted to build a great city, but they didn't want it to be centered around God. They wanted it to be centered around a tower. And then they said, we're going to build the tower so high till it'll penetrate into heaven.
Amen.
Boy, them some bad fellas, wasn't it? Yeah. Good God Almighty. Folks had been praying for 300 years and couldn't get in heaven. And they were going to build a tower. Well, they could climb up.
Amen.
They wanted to bypass God.
Yeah.
Look at your neighbor and said, don't bypass God. I just did that so you'll wake him up. But anyway, don't bypass God. Don't bypass the laws of God. But they wanted to bypass God and his process. They wanted to bypass the grave. They wanted to bypass death. They wanted to bypass salvation. They wanted to bypass grace. They wanted to bypass morality. They wanted to be dirty, short, half-taught, and go into heaven just like they were. But heaven is a prepared place for and for bad people. Ooh. They wanted to go to heaven just like they were. And Lord, if you want to make some money, you go out there and build you a tower now where folk can just get into heaven. And Lord, see, folks who broke up other folks' homes will be the first one in line. No, you took that man's wife, and no, it's going to be hard for you to get into heaven because she done put you in hell while you're down here. But if we could just get a tower. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. I know that I'm a woman, but I love the softness and the sweetness of another woman. I know I can't get into heaven through the regular gate, but if you can just build a tower, me and my woman with her ring on her finger and my ring on my finger, we can walk into heaven just like we are.
Yeah.
Oh, look at me like I'm crazy.